What's up, Gospel Chops? Here we go once again with another exclusive feature. We got my man, Mr. Justin Raines, all the way from Boston, Massachusetts. If there ever was a Gospel Chops all-star, this is the man right here. We get more emails and requests for this cat around the world, probably more than anyone else who's ever been featured on Gospel Chops. It's definitely an honor to have him back with us. Got a special announcement that we're going to make at the end of this clip for bass players around Boston, New England area. So stay tuned. Right now, Mr. Raines is going to show us a little something we can do on the bass. A little chop, a little lick, something we can use and apply to gospel music. Justin Raines, what you got for us?
Well, let me first say, you know, what an honor it is to be able to do this video again with Gerald Forrest. I wouldn't have as much publicity as I have if it wasn't for this man of God right here, you know, Gerald Forrest, with him, you know, going around seeking out, you know, young musicians and up and coming musicians and just to, you know, shine light on the young ones that are out there. So I appreciate that, you know, from the heart. You know, we've been good friends, you know, since the first video. When I was at NAMM show, you know, we've been just, you know, just great friends. You know what I mean? He looks out for me, and I, whatever I can do to look out for him, you know, I will do. You know, but I just had to say that, you know, first. I'm really honored. I'm really honored to be back. Just to let you know. You know, but the thing that I wanted to show on bass, It's a pretty advanced, maybe intermediate thing. It's important for us bass players to know our bass. One thing that I'm going to do is it's chordal inversions, and it's not just for you, you know, playing your bass, but to get to know your bass whenever you're playing for someone else. But I'm gonna start on the key of D flat, and I tune regular. You know, some gospel players, tune to B flat, some tune to A. I tune to B. It's just personal preference, you know. I don't think anyone is better, but that's what I do. So I'm gonna start in D flat, and I'm gonna play the root, which is D flat, the fifth, which is A flat, and then the third on top, which is F. Simple D flat major chord.
Step down in C.
four string, you know, bass players starting A flat. So A flat, E flat, C. That goes with the C. A flat, E flat. Then the E flat, C. Six string, so I respect that, I understand that. So, and we go to G flat, that right there will help you so much whenever you're doing licks, whenever you're, because you understand what key you're in. So if you're in key of D flat, you know, certain levels. You know what I mean? Very, very, it's very simple once you get it. It's the simple things that'll make everything, when we put it together, it'll sound very intricate, especially when it's in the right place. So that was just one thing I wanted to expound on. Another thing was, you know, it's actual lick. You can do it in any key, because it's more so based on your positions. I'm going to do it in D flat again, and it's a major run, you know what I mean? And it starts on the third of whatever key you're in. So we're in D flat or C sharp. It will start on the F. So I'm going to start it. Lick is, I'll do it again because I was real sloppy, not bad. That's better. So that's the lick. And all it is I'm arpeggiating the D flat major 7 chord. I'm arpeggiating that starting on 3 or starting on the F. So this is this slow. For my four string players, you know. Basis of that lick is just arpeggiating. You know, learn your arp, your simple arpeggios, and that one just happened to be over a major seven. You know, there's minor seven chords, there's augmented seven chords, there's diminished seven chords. There's so many different chords that you can arpeggiate over. Man, and doing something as simple as to share the knowledge that I have with as many people as I can. You know, I thank God for it, and I want to share it. But if you're interested, you can email me at jraines.lessons@gmail.com. That's jraines.lessons, lessons, @gmail.com. And I'll get back to you as soon as I can. I check my email every day, and I'm trying to make this thing real. So if you're interested, give me a shout, and send me an email, and we'll go from there. Like I said, for Boston and New England residents, we may start immediately. But for my people that don't live in Boston, working on these online thing, these online lessons, so I can share it with you as well. So, but I thank everyone for your support. It means a lot to hear from Gerald that people are asking, you know, where's Justin Raines, you know, so like it means a lot to me, and I'm humbled, you know, I thank God for this gift and this talent, and I want to give back. So that's the big announcement. So if you're interested, you know, send me an email.
There you have it, everybody. Gospel Chops exclusive announcement. You wanted him. Here he is. You emailed. You asked about him. The lessons are official. Come down to Boston. Get your chops together. Sit with the man himself. Justin Raines is officially giving lessons.